Hi, my name's Mark Thurston and I'm the Chief Executive of HS2. And I'm delighted to bring you this, the first of a series of progress videos we're going to be doing to show just the sheer volume of activity we've now got right across the HS2 project. 2022 is proving to be a massive year for us. We've got over 25,000 people now working on the project, over 900 of those are now apprentices, some 2,500 businesses working right across the country on the project, on the section between London and Birmingham where we're most advanced. We have all three phases now are active. I'm here today at the Convoy Viaduct site. This is just inside the M25 in northwest London. This huge bridge building machine behind me will build what will become Britain's largest railway viaduct, nearly 3.5 kilometres long, heading south from here. Over the coming months here, what the team will be doing using this machinery is putting over 1,000 segments between here and going further south, the 2 miles, which will be an iconic piece of engineering in this part of the route. Once this viaduct is complete, the trains will be travelling up 200 miles per hour across this iconic structure. So as much as that's some years away, this is a really pivotal moment for us today as we've launched this girder behind us. This is just one of over 300 sites we've got active on phase one, the section between Birmingham and London. We're on site at 2 of our 4 stations. We've got 3 tunnelling machines in the ground, 2 in fact not far from here and nearly 3 miles under the Chilterns. And further south of here, our construction teams just down at West Ruislip are getting ready to launch our 4th tunnelling machine to make its way towards London. Building HS2, of course, is more than just a railway. It's an opportunity for the sector to really look at the way we design and build big infrastructure like this. So reducing carbon in the built environment is crucial. We've now got our first diesel-free site. We've issued our net zero carbon reduction plan. There's lots of work going on across HS2 to find ways of reducing carbon in what we build, but also making sure that we leave a net zero railway behind us. Engagement along the line of route with communities is important to us, and it's great that so far we've committed 11.9 million to community, environment and business funds to over 205 projects on all the route. These are projects that are really valuable to the local communities, whether it's sports facilities for children, local community facilities for local business to get engaged. It's people working locally with us to decide what's important for them, and that's where this valuable money goes into these projects. We're very aware at HS2 of the impact of building this railway on the natural environment. So it's great that so far we've already created 100 new natural habitats along the line of route. As we really transition from spring into summer, it's great to see some of these natural sites really start to come into their full bloom and colour. And we're well on the way to planting some of the 7 million trees and bushes that we will plant right along the route to create the green corridor, so the final railway is very sympathetic to the local and natural environment. At the end of last year, we appointed Hitachi Alstom as the joint venture to design and build our trains. So from day one, when we open this railway, we'll be able to run those trains from the high-speed system much further north onto the existing system, into Manchester, and further north all the way into Scotland. We've now got great momentum on HS2. And frankly, 2022 is going to be a fantastic year for us. It's our biggest year yet, and we're going to now hit our peak period on HS2. And hopefully these updates give you a bit of insight into what we're up to on this game-changing project. We'll be right back.